Here we have two beakers, both filled with coloured water, in order to test the idea of a subglacial lake on the South Pole of Mars. To one of the beakers, we are going to add ordinary table salt, sodium chloride, which is often used in order to remove ice, such as with road grit. The other beaker is left as plain tap water as a control with which we can compare our results. The table salt is thoroughly stirred into one solution that we see here on the right. And then our solution has to be cooled. We have opted to use dry ice, solid carbon dioxide for this. Carbon dioxide is solid at any temperature below minus 80 degrees Celsius, so this should be very, very effective in cooling our two solutions. As the dry ice contacts the water, which is far warmer, we'll see a lot of this mist, that is condensation from the water vapor in the air. As the reaction becomes less vigorous, it's necessary for us to add even more dry ice to ensure that we get the maximum potential of freezing in our two samples. Now it can take some time for this to freeze, so now we have to wait. As one of our samples completely froze through, we did, however, encounter a bit of a surprise. The ice froze to the point where it disconnected from the beaker, allowing this block of ice to raise upwards. Now we will compare our two samples. The one on the right, as you'll remember, is a saline solution full of salt. The one on the left was simply tap water with food colouring. Our sample on the right with the salt has formed a thick slush, whereas the one without the salt has frozen completely solid. See this once more with a closer inspection, that yes, the salt solution is very, very thick and slushy, but not entirely frozen through, in a stark contrast to our solution without the salt, which is completely frozen.